Hello grade 5 and welcome to our new lesson which is multiplication of decimals. This is session 1. To multiply a decimal by a natural number or to multiply two decimal numbers together, first of all, you should review the multiplication tables. Please review them because we need them while we are multiplying numbers. We also have to remember how can we multiply any two natural numbers using the vertical way. Example, multiply 5731 times 25. To multiply these two numbers, first of all, we have to write them in the vertical form. And we start multiplying by the ones of the second number. We multiply the ones by each digit of the first number. So we multiply 5 by 5731. So 5 times 1 is 5. 5 times 3, it's 15, 5 and 1 carry out. 5 times 7, it's 35 plus 1, which is 36, and 5 times 5, it's 25. Added to it, 3, it will be 28. Next, we put 0 or we leave an empty digit because we want to move from 1s to 10s. So we put 0 or we leave an empty digit. So now, next, we multiply 2 by each digit of the first number. Let's start. 2 times 1, it's 2. 2 times 3, it's 6. 2 times 7, it's 14. 4 and 1 carry out. 2 times 5 is 10 plus 1, which is 11. You can cross out the carry out of the first result so you will not get any confused. Then, what to do? We add the results starting from right to left. 5 plus 0 is 5, 2 plus 5 is 7, 6 plus 6 is 12, 1 carry out, 8 plus 4 is 12, plus 3 which is 13, 1 carry out, 2 plus 1 plus 1 is 4, and here you get 4. So our final answer will be 143,275. Don't forget to put a comma after three digits to the right. So this is our final answer, or we can say this is the product of 5731 and 25. Okay, now what if one of the numbers is decimal? What to do if you want to multiply two numbers and one of them is a decimal number? To multiply a decimal number by a natural number, you have to follow these steps. Let's take an example and apply the steps. Example 1. Multiply 57.31 times 25. Step 1. Write the multiplied numbers in the vertical form. So, let's write them in the vertical form. As usual, when I want to multiply any two numbers, we write them in the vertical form. But look. Step 2. Multiply without taking the point into consideration. As we did before, look here, I didn't put the decimal point. So I'm ignoring the decimal point. Let's multiply as if there is no decimal point. How to multiply? We start with the ones and multiply it by the first number. So multiply 5 times 1, which is 5. 5 times 3, 15. 1 carry out, 5 times 7, then 5 times 5, and write the answer. Then, 1. You want to move from the 1s to the 10s, you put 0 or you leave an empty digit. And then you multiply 2 with the first numbers. But you can cross these carry out numbers, so then you can continue. So let's multiply 2 by 5731. 2 times 1, which is 2. 2 times 3, 6. 2 times 7, 14. 4 and 1 carry out. 2 times 5 is 10 and 1, which is 11. When you finish, you add the answers starting from right to left. And this is our final product. Now, what to do? Step 3, we have to put the point in the product. How? Count the number of decimal places to insert the decimal point in the product. Look here at the explanation. After multiplying 57.31 by 25, the answer is below, which is 143,275. But we didn't find the final answer because we have to put the decimal point. How? We count the number of decimal places in the decimal number. Here we have 1, 2 decimal places, or in other words, we have 2 digits in the decimal part. So here we have 2 digits, so we have to enter the decimal point 2 digits. Okay, so in the answer or in the product, we will have also 2 digits in the decimal part. So here is our final answer, which is 1,432.75. Now, let's solve the following example. This is example 2. We want to multiply 2.526 times 314. Let's follow the below steps. Step 1, number 1, we said that to multiply any two numbers, we have to write them in the vertical form. So, we arrange them in the vertical form, then we multiply without taking the point into consideration. So, let's write them in the vertical form. In such a way, we don't take into consideration the decimal point. And we start multiplying with the ones of the second number, which is 4. 4, we multiply it by 2,526. We will get 4 times 6, which is 24, 2 carry out, 4 times 2, which is 8, plus 2, it's 10, 4 times 5, it's 20, and plus 1, which is 21, 4 times 2, it's 8, plus 2, which will give you 10. Now, when you move from one digit to the second one, we have to put 0 under the ones, because we are moving to the tens, or we leave an empty space. And we multiply 1 similarly by the first number. You can cross out the carryouts so you will not feel any confused. Let's continue. 1 times 6, which is 6. 1 times 2, it's 2. 1 times 5, it's 5. 1 times 2, it's 2. Next, we finished the tens. Now we want to move to the hundreds. So we have to put 2 zeros under the ones and tens, or you can leave 2 empty digits. Now we multiply 3 by the first number. 3 times 6, it's 18. 1 carry out. 3 times 2, it's 6 plus 1, which is 7. 3 plus 5, it's 15. 1 carry out. 3 times 2, which is 6, plus 1, which is 7. Now we finished multiplication. What to do? Now we have to add the answers, starting from right to left. 4 plus 0 plus 0, it's 4. 6, 8 plus 2, 10, plus 1, 11. 1 carry out. And 5 plus 7, it's 12, plus 1, 13. Now here, adding them, 5 plus 2, 7, plus 1, 8, 1 carry out, it's 9, and here we have 7. Now, what shall we do after finding the product? Don't forget to put the decimal point. How? We count the number of decimal digits in the decimal part, or we have to count the digits found in the decimal part of the decimal number. Here is the decimal number. How many digits we have in the decimal part? We have 1, 2, 3 digits. So here the decimal point will enter 1, 2, 3 digits. Here is the decimal point. So our final answer is 793.164. So as we said, we count the number of the decimal places to enter the decimal point to the answer. We found that we have 3 digits in the decimal part. So we entered the decimal point 1, 2, 3 digits. So here is the decimal point. Our answer is 793. By this, we finished our session. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.